Mallory and I are out on a walk, a jog,
oh my God,
and a run! So yesterday, I was talking about intentions and tension, but I had meant to talk about intention. Like, with my currency business, I would have these times when I'd meet in coffee shops with piles of Iraqi dinar, and the people coming would have, you know, the amount of cash that was needed. Sometimes it was 20 grand, sometimes 30. So obviously the reason we didn't have any more cash than that and we'd split it up in different meetings is for security reasons for both of us, but I never knew the intentions that people had. So this is the dark part of intentions. If they know that you're an international currency dealer and to do the exchange, you're gonna have to bring a lot of cash with you. That means that at some point over hundreds and hundreds of coffee shops and booths, that somebody is going to maybe have ill intentions and want to take the money and not give anything in return. So what we used to do is, you know, I'd watch these spy movies and get ideas to see what they would do, so then I didn't have to sort of learn from experience. And they'd always sit in these booths, because booths would have three sides covered and only one side not. And I would order whatever I needed to order, like a drink, you know, a water or a Diet Coke or something. And then I would tell the waitress that we didn't need anything for a while, and I'd flag her down if we did. And so that way, people would still be walking by, but at least you'd have things blocked off. When you know, I took out a bunch of Iraqi dinar and they took out a bunch of cash and we exchanged it. It wasn't like it was on the table for minutes, but still, it's a lot of security risk. We're going to a place called the Spy House with a bag full of prop money because I'm working on ideas for how to film scenes that are similar to what I, you know, lived.
I dig it.
Hi.
So this isn't exactly how this would go, but this is all we got for today, so let's just go with it. So here's what we got, right? Now we would do something like that. Something like this. Maybe you want a brick? Hurry up, get this stuff in your LV. So we'd be a little more discreet about it, but this is pretty fun since it's prop money. So I think I've handed you like $200,000. So that'll be good for now. But obviously this would happen in reverse. What happens is I bring the Iraqi dinar and they bring the cash and we switch. But I felt like since I'm out of that business, there was no use in trying to get tens of thousands of dollars worth of Iraqi dinar to do this for real. Now I may, when I finish the book and start to promote it, I'll probably do stuff like that. I'll have to put on little promo events and stuff, so you'll see different things. This is a little childish right now, I get it, but it's allowing me to think about promo ideas. And we'll see where it goes. So you guys will see where it started now and then where it ends. I used to meet clients in coffee shops in McLean, Virginia. I'd sit at a booth and wait for them to arrive. The thing about a booth is that three sides are blocked from view. The amount of Iraqi dinar I'd bring depended on the client, but most days were between 10 million to 20 million Iraqi dinar. They'd then bring between 10,000 to 30,000 US dollars cash. On that note, that's a wrap.